What is the meaning of temporary, portable, and demountable architecture? This video started with a poll that we published in our YouTube community. In that poll, we asked if you'd be interested in a video about temporary health structures. During our research on the topic, we found a very interesting book called Architecture in Motion. So instead of covering the health sector alone and how every country in the world is increasing its medical capacity to push back against the coronavirus, we decided to get a more general look on the origins and growth of the temporary structures, and what differentiates them from temporary buildings. Honestly, we did not want to waste an opportunity to share all of this knowledge with you. The first human existence is traced back to 2 million years ago. The first human settlement appeared 10,000 years ago. Our survival as a species relied on mobility. So before we start, please hit the like and subscribe buttons, the notification bell, and check our new Patreon page. This will really help us keep this channel alive. 1. The origins of temporary architecture. The permanent housing concept did not exist at the prehistorical ages, and it wasn't even introduced for many thousands of years. The shelter was just another tool to survive, just like a weapon. This tool was used as a cover during traveling and was crucial for the survival of humanity. Our ancestors used what was available in nature to cover them. They assembled and disassembled their structures based on the site condition and the changes of seasons. Temporary architecture can be divided into two main categories. 1. Demountable structures, such as the Native American tents or the Bedouin desert tents. And 2. Movable structures, like the lightweight hut of Africa and the boathouse of the Far East. If you'd like us to go more into the prehistorical shelters and how it was perfected, please let us know in the comment section below. Anyway, because of this temporal property, most of the details of the prehistorical dwellings were lost with time. But we should not ignore the prehistorical architecture and exclude it from our studies as architects. It actually shows us how a group of people addressed geographical, logistical, and constructional issues with trial and error during a long period of time. These early structures resembled the nature pattern of cohesion with itself. It was what we call vernacular architecture, a form of biomimetics. Check out our video on the subject in the links below. For now, we still have a lot to uncover about portable, lightweight architecture, so let's move on. 2. Temporary and the permanent age. After settling down, lightweight homes were replaced by fixed and permanent dwellings. For the civilized settlers, lightweight structures served specific functions. The Romans used demountable props for their shows and festivities at the Colosseum. The roof of the Colosseum itself was technically a temporary structure, raised by experienced sailors when needed. In fact, works of lightweight kinetic engineering presents itself all over the European entertainment history. In 1520, a large temporary palace was erected in France near Calais. The banqueting house of Henry VIII, a structure of 37 meters in diameter and 40 meters high. The building of timber structure is reflected in the design of circuses to this day. The Branham and Bailey Greatest Show on Earth utilized 14 demountable tents, covering a minimal area of 200 by 300 meters. It toured Europe for several times. While the entertainment industry occupied itself with optimizing the lightweight tents, colonial Europe utilized the concept for a different purpose. Britain developed prefabricated homes and field hospitals to be shipped abroad for quick erection. In 1830, John Manning, a carpenter from London, mass-produced the colonial cottage. This house was designed to be easily erected with repetitive elements. The elements utilized a small volume and were efficient for transportation. Prefabricated modular housing came in different forms and designs. The colonial empires did not only build movable houses, they also shipped churches and banks. The prefabricated structures reached North America in the same way. The British Army needed lightweight movable structures for their campaigns. However, due to the rich lands and forests of the region, prefabricated construction quickly turned into the local resources instead of shipping overseas. The two main points to keep from this part are: 1. Prefabricated, lightweight, temporary, and movable structures are a product of the engineering inventions and the knowledge in material use. These structures that started with logwood and animal skins evolved to timber and cast iron in recent history. And 2. Architecture history played a major role in reflecting the power and cultures of the builders. Temporary structure, on the other hand, is by default built or prefabricated for a specific goal in mind. Temporary is a product of engineering. 3. Wars, disasters, and shelters. War is known as the fastest driver of innovation. Both world wars took advantage of the industrial technologies at the time and then propelled it significantly. The creation rate during the time of conflict dwarfs what is achieved during peace. Armies involved in the wars required different forms of movable structures for logistics and other purposes. They set basic principles for portable structures. 1. It should adapt to different site conditions. 2. It should have a flexible layout. 3. It should be easy to transport and deploy. And finally, 4. It should be cheap to manufacture. The wars brought to us floating structures, movable hangars, and assembled bridges. During the D-Day, the Allied forces deployed 2 complete floating harbors. These massive temporary structures were used as the main ports and one of the main reasons for winning the war. When it comes to the military inventions, the structure that we are mostly interested in is the Nissen hut. This lightweight shelter can accommodate from 24 to 48 men when needed. It utilizes simple components that are easy to assemble and manufacture. With some additions, it can also be used as a hospital hut or a cafeteria. During the First World War, the Nissen hut was the home for 500,000 soldiers. Nissen-shaped huts are still in use today. The second military structure that we will briefly mention is the MUST hospital. It is another successful design for portable and demountable units. It consists of an inflatable dual wall, and once fully deployed, it can withstand a lot of wind load. Due to its ability to be deployed next to combat fields, it was able to save many lives. War, however, is not the only disaster that can inflict itself on a peaceful society. Natural disasters can sometimes be more devastating to a community or to a whole country. Experienced and respected architects such as Alvaro Aalto and Chiguro Ban are devoting time and energy for the creation of new prototypes for disaster relief situations. With time, post-disaster shelters to host refugees proved to be complex and difficult to manage. But this did not limit the creativity of finding temporary solutions in this field. Chiguro Ban successfully deployed paper-based structures as a quick architectural response for the people in need. And finally, epidemics like the recent COVID-19 proved to be another type of disaster where temporary structures can be used. China managed the prefabrication and assembly of the Hushenshan Hospital in 10 days. Other countries transformed halls, ships, football fields, and whatever available spaces into hospitals. Just like our prehistorical ancestors, temporary structures are still a functional tool that can be used where and when needed. 4. Portable architecture. The only constant in human existence is change. Works of architecture that stood the test of time are few and require costly restoration to keep them standing. So if we are to extend our perspective beyond our lifespan by a little bit, it will be clear to us that even permanent buildings come and go all the time. Most of the buildings in your city are probably 100 years old. What stood before them is now long gone. Permanent buildings are rare and require a lot of energy to preserve. Architecture could be defined as a human-made sense of place. The Sahara Bedouins constantly moved their whole societies. Unlike their changing environments, their tents were constant. It provided their sense of space and belonging. Tents are their living spaces and community structures. It is organized like a settlement with the possibility to change land when needed. Within this context, a tent, a hut, or even a moving submarine is the settling place of its users. It is their home or their needed architecture. Portable architecture will not replace permanent architecture. It serves a different function. But with the rise of the internet and new movements such as the digital nomads, portable architecture is giving a new hope of living free and working while exploring nature. It can be our gateway to reconnect with our origins and with the earth. 5. Final say. In this video, we did not go into the details of any of the structures mentioned. If you guys chose an interest on the topic, we can make more videos about it. Every successful temporary structure from the prehistorical ages onward holds some sophisticated engineering quality. Covering them all will require a lot of effort. So please let us know what you think, and again, please consider supporting us on our new Patreon page. If you made it till the end of this video, we really appreciate it. Please stay safe and see you in the next one.